Morning to all. Today I am going to start with the chapter Skin, the Jack of All Trades. And in today's lecture, we will discuss about functions of skin in detail. So children, we will start with today's lecture. And before starting with the lecture, I would like to discuss the various objectives of the topic. So in today's lecture, we will discuss about various functions of skin, regulation of body temperature in detail, and we will also discuss about the terms, various terms. These are enzymes, denaturation, vasoconstriction, vasodilation, cold-blooded animals, warm-blooded animals, hibernation and estivation. So children, let's start with the today's lecture and kindly open up your books at page number 13.5. Functions of skin. The skin is not merely the outer wrapper of the body, but it also performs many diverse functions. The various functions performed by the skin are protection, water loss prevention, regulation of body temperature, safety against sunburns, barrier to germs and poison, excretion, sensation and secretion storage. And the last function is synthesis. So let's start with the very first function, that is protection. Children, we have already studied in our previous lecture about integumentary system. We know integumentary system contains skin proper and skin derivatives. Skin proper further divided into epidermis and dermis, and skin derivatives are further divided into hair, cutaneous glands and nails. Children, we have studied epidermis in detail, and we know the different five layers of epidermis are stratum corneum, stratum lucidum, stratum granulosum, stratum spinosum and stratum basale. And we have made a shortcut for that, that is CLGSB. Children, we know the cells of stratum corneum layer are dead cells, and these dead cells contain keratin. And keratin is a waterproof material. Stratum corneum resists the action of external agencies like germs, and it protects the internal vital structures from mechanical injury and bacterial invasions. Next is water loss prevention. The outer horny layers of epidermis are impermeable. The word impermeable means it does not allow anything to pass through it and prevents the loss of water from the body due to evaporation. Next is regulation of body temperature. So children, before starting with this function, I would like to introduce few terms. Look here. Children, we have studied about enzymes in digestive system chapter. We know enzymes are biocatalysts, and enzymes work best between 35 to 40 degrees Celsius. And at low temperature, they cease to catalyze the reaction. Means they become functionally inactive. And above 45 degrees Celsius, they undergo denaturation. Now what is denaturation? Denaturation means inactivation of enzymes by changing its shape due to high temperature. Children, this term is quite important. Some of the living animals are able to keep their body temperature constant between 35 to 40 degrees Celsius, and they are called warm-blooded animals. Now children, what are warm-blooded animals? Look here. Warm-blooded animals are the animals which keep their body temperature constant. That is, they cannot regulate their body temperature according to change in surrounding. An example for warm-blooded animals are human beings and aves, means birds. Next are cold-blooded animals. Cold-blooded animals are the animals which cannot keep their body temperature constant. That is, they can regulate their body temperature according to change in surroundings. For example, lizards. So children, these cold-blooded animals undergo hibernation during winter season and estivation during summer season. Now, what is this hibernation and estivation? Look here. Again, these are two new terms. Hibernation. Hibernation is defined as a long winter sleep of animals, and aestivation is defined as the summer sleep of animals. Children, we can compare these two terms, hibernation and aestivation. Look here. Hibernation is also known as winter sleep, and aestivation is also known as summer sleep. In case of hibernation, animals look for a warm place to sleep. And in case of aestivation, animals look for a moist place and shady place to sleep. Hibernation is for longer duration and aestivation is for shorter duration. Hibernation prevents any internal body damage due to low temperature, and aestivation prevents excessive water loss and internal body damage due to high temperature. And these are their examples. Bats, mammals, birds in case of hibernation, and in case of aestivation, snail, earthworms and frogs. Children, to regulate the body temperature, mammals and birds possesses a thermoregulatory mechanism, and this mechanism works under the control of hypothalamic thermostatic center, and this mechanism mainly involves skin. So children, for this mechanism we have two terms. These are vasodilation and vasoconstriction. These two terms are again very, very important. Now, to make these terms very easy, we will break the word. Vaso means blood vessels and dilation means to expand. So, vasodilation means expansion of blood vessels, which increases the blood supply towards the surface of skin. Look at this diagram. In this diagram, the blood vessels, they become expand. They get expanded, and when the blood vessels they expand, the more blood supply will be there and more blood will flow towards the surface of skin, and maximum heat is lost in the form of sweat, and this process occurs during summer season. Next is vasoconstriction. Vasoconstriction. Vaso means blood vessel, constriction means to contract. Vasoconstriction is defined as a process in which blood vessels they contract, which results in decreasing blood supply. Now look at this diagram. Look here, the blood vessels, they are very narrow. Due to narrow blood vessels, less blood flow will be towards the surface of skin, and minimum heat is lost in the form of sweat. That is, heat is retained inside the body. Now children, to make this concept more easy, look here. Children, see, vasodilation and vasoconstriction. Now, vasodilation, it occurs during summer season. Outside temperature is high, and blood vessels will expand, and the flow of blood towards the surface of skin, it increases, and maximum heat is lost in the form of sweat. But in case of vasoconstriction, vasoconstriction occurs during winter season. And outside temperature is low. Blood vessels will contract, and flow of blood towards the surface of skin, it decreases, and a minimum heat is lost in the form of sweat. That is, heat is retained inside the body. Children, this difference is also very important. You will note this difference on your copies. So children, this is how skin helps in regulation of body temperature. Next function is safety against sunburns. We know the color of skin is due to a pigment called melanin, and melanin is secreted by melanocytes, which are present beneath the epidermal cells. And melanin absorbs ultraviolet rays of the sun, and ultraviolet rays can cause sunburns. Next function is barrier to germs and poison. The outer horny layer of epidermis is very good barrier, and this layer prevents the entry of bacteria and other microorganisms, and also it is impermeable. We have done this term earlier. It is impermeable to poison which comes in contact with the skin. Children, next function is excretion. Sweat secreted by sweat glands consists of water, salts, urea and carbon dioxide, and all these are excreted products. Now children, look here. We have this diagram already discussed in our previous lecture. Children, look at this diagram. In this diagram, these are highly coiled sweat glands, and these sweat glands are present in dermis portion. These sweat glands are having sweat ducts, and these sweat ducts, they opens at the surface of epidermis with the help of pore called sweat pores. So sweat is produced by sweat glands, and this sweat is excreted by these sweat pores. And sweat consists of various excretory products which I have discussed right now. Next function is secretions. The glands present in the skin secretes various useful substances. Now children, look here. The various glands of skin are sweat glands, sebaceous glands, mammary glands, meibomian glands and sebaceous glands. Children, we know, we have right now discussed about sweat glands. Sweat glands secretes sweats which contains excretory products. We have discussed right now. Next are sebaceous glands. These are also known as oil glands. These are the sebaceous glands. Sebaceous glands are lobulated glands which contains many sacs. See, so many sacs are there that opens into the hair follicle. This is hair follicle, and they opens into the hair follicles by a common duct. So children, actually the oil glands or sebaceous glands are formed as a out pushing of hair follicle. See, they are formed as a out pushing of hair follicle, and the glandular epithelium of these glands secretes an oily secretion called sebum, and the sebum lubricates the hair and make it oily and waterproof. Next are mammary glands. Children, we know mammary glands are also known as milk glands, and these are modified sweat glands. These are functional in female after a birth of young one and remain so till the sucking continues, and they are non-functional in male. And children, mammary gland secretes milk, and milk nourishes the young ones, and it is a complete food for them. Next are meibomian glands. Meibomian glands secretes oily secretions that keeps the eyelids oily. Actually, meibomian glands are modified sebaceous glands, and these glands open at the margins of eyelids in the hair follicles of eyelashes, and they secrete an oily secretion that keeps the eyelids oily and soft, flexible and frictionless. Next are sebaceous glands. Sebaceous glands are also modified sweat glands, and they are found in the hinder parts of external auditory canal. They secrete cerumen, a waxy secretion, and it is also known as ear wax, and it lubricates and protects the eardrum. The next function of skin is sensation. A variety of stimuli such as touch, heat, cold, pain, humidity, chemicals and pressures are perceived by the skin. Now children, look here. We know the dermis portion. This is the dermis portion. Dermis portion contains so many nerve fibers, and due to these nerve fibers, skin is sensitive to touch, heat, cold, pain, humidity, chemicals and pressure. And due to these nerve fibers, due to these sort of sensations, skin protect us from various dreadful circumstances. Next function is storage. Subcutaneous layer of the skin help in storage of fats and water. Now children, look here. We have done this diagram earlier in our previous lecture. These are the three layers of the skin. So subcutaneous layer, this last layer is subcutaneous layer. This layer helps in storage of fats and water. The next function is synthesis. Vitamin D is synthesized by ultraviolet rays of the sun acting upon ergosterol present in the skin and subcutaneous tissue. Now children, look here. The skin is responsible for producing vitamins D. The epidermal layer of the human skin synthesizes vitamin D when exposed to ultraviolet radiation. In the presence of sunlight, a form of vitamin D3 called cholecalciferol is synthesized from a derivative of steroid cholesterol in the skin. So the liver converts cholecalciferol to calcitriol, and calcitriol is an active chemical form of vitamin D. So children, this is how the vitamin D is synthesized. Next topic is regulation of body temperature and role of the skin. Actually, we have done this concept right now. And to make it more clear, just look here. We know enzymes are biocatalysts and they can work best between the temperature range of 35 to 40 degrees Celsius. And below 35 degrees Celsius, and below this temperature, their activity ceases. And above 45 degrees Celsius, they undergo denaturation. We have done the term denaturation right now. Some of the living animals are able to keep their body temperature constant. They are called warm-blooded animals. We have discussed right now. And children, warm-blooded animals are also known as homeothermals or endothermals. Whereas cold-blooded animals, which we have discussed right now, are also known as poikilothermals or ectothermals. So cold-blooded animals undergo hibernation during winter season and estivation during summer season. We have discussed now. So children, we know this temperature can be maintained with the help of a body activity. These body activities are expiration. We know what is expiration. Removal of foul air from the lungs. Urination, the process of removal of urine out from the body. Defecation, the process of removal of feces out from the body. We have done these terms earlier. Changing rate of metabolism, environmental temperature variation, physical works and exercises, etc. All these exercises helps to maintain the temperature constant. So for the purpose we have done, a mechanism is there. That mechanism is known as thermoregulatory mechanism, which is controlled by hypothalamus located in the brain. So children, this diagram at page number 13.7 shows the process of vasodilation very clearly. So you can have a very clear idea from here also. This diagram also shows the process of vasoconstriction. So children, we have done the concept of vasodilation, vasoconstriction earlier very clearly. So children, it was all about today's lecture, and we will start with the next lecture in our next class. Kindly do all the question answers related to the topic, mark them on the book, and write reasoning questions, differences, terms on your copies. Thank you so much.